today's generation, we strive to be busy, and busyness has become a word we use to tell others that we are doing well. It means that your business is thriving, you are an essential employee, and that's the reason why we wear it like a badge of honor. But let us get this misconception off our heads, because what we want to strive for is being productive and being able to fully utilize our time meaningfully, not being busy for the sake of being busy. You guys know I started minimalism because I want to be frugal, but I love the productivity that comes with it. And that's one of the main reasons why I love minimalism so much, because it increases my productivity. How, you might ask? So let me start with the first, which is one of the most obvious, the space. Having less gives us more physical space to work, no matter if you are working at home or working in the office. The area we work in should be free from clutter. Unless you are like Gary Vee, who can perform in chaotic environment, then maybe you are watching the wrong video. Most of us can only stay productive when our surroundings are clean and organized. We are juggling different projects at the same time, and our to-do list is piling up. The worst thing we can do is add more physical clutter and create redundant stress and eyesore for ourselves. So, having a clutter-free space is the first step to keep yourself productive. Take some time to clear the clutter off your working space every day before you start your work. Making your workspace free from distraction, easy to locate things, and no mess for you to worry when it's time to focus. The same thing works for your digital clutter as well, whether it is your email, phone, or computer. Remove distraction. When it comes to focusing, anything can be my distraction, but nothing beats the addictiveness of my phone. The urge of picking up my phone can be triggered by any notifications, or even just a sudden thought of checking how my social media friends are doing currently. So, instead of testing our limits to fight the distractions, I've learned to remove the trigger and introduce friction when it comes to distractions. We can save our energy by hiding what's redundant for the job and only have the essential present. Shutting down notifications and turning on your airplane mode can be the best friend of productivity. But I guess you wouldn't have this issue when you're working in the office. But if you're working from home, when no one is looking over your back, then we need to be our own accountability partner. And check it, while you're editing this, please don't tell me you can edit while watching YouTube videos. You clearly can't multitask, so please focus. System. Having less automatically creates a system that can help us to organize and store things neatly, because it makes things straightforward and simple. Not just that, it also reduces our decision fatigue. That's when we can standardize the tools we use. Whether it is storage space, writing software, filming equipment, we know what to use and where to find it when they are needed. That saves us a lot of time when you are finding specific items. And it's all done by having the essential and removing the extras. It makes our system straightforward and requires little brain energy to operate. That being said, it also helps me to deal with analysis paralysis. I call them the time and energy waster. I'm pretty indecisive. Once I have more than one option to choose from, I'll be stuck in the paradox of choice, because I wouldn't want to regret my decision. I'll take my time, overanalyze, and hours wasted just because I can't decide which software to use. So by standardizing and sticking to one tool, that can save a lot of our time and brain energy. Next is priority. There can only be one. You probably hear this a lot from other minimalists or from this channel, but I have to emphasize this again. Priority. It's a singular word, and it meant the very first. It's only during the 20th century we pluralized the word and give ourselves multiple priorities. It may sound counterintuitive, but having tons of priorities doesn't make us more productive. In fact, it dilutes the word and loses its sense of urgency. There's only so much time we have in one day, and one third of it has to go to sleep, no matter how much we like it or not. So even if we squeeze everything in one day, there's only so much we can do. We often have different projects and exams we need to juggle at the same time, but I never believed that multitasking is a productive tool. In fact, it's one that distracts our focus and prevent us from getting into the flow of deep focus and the enjoyment of our work. So what we want to do is only have one priority in mind at a time. That's how we can channel all of our energy on one task, the most urgent, the most important, the one we value the most. I try to keep my priorities as simple as possible. I might have a few priorities within a day, but only focus on one priority at a time. We can also create a to-do list that aligns with our priority. Of course, with great focus, sometimes we can complete our to-do list even before the given time. That's when we can introduce new tasks that aligns with our new priority. Mental clutter blocks brain activities. When it comes to productivity, we can't separate it from our brain. It's our brain decision to choose what to put our focus on. Just like a horror movie, what scares us the most is the unknown. And that's mental clutter to me. And that's one of the worst enemies for my productivity. Mental clutter, being intangible, is one of the hardest to remove. We can't physically or permanently remove it from our minds. So we need to be more conscious when our minds are cluttered with unnecessary thoughts. We can do a quick meditation session or take a short break. I have an in-depth video on how we can declutter our mind. If you are interested, you can check it out after this. But what's crucial is, we have to remember to start with a blank canvas. If the mind is cluttered, there's almost no way we can stay focused and be productive. Work with less time. Having less time allocated to certain tasks allows us to make use of the time effectively. That's when the Parkinson's law comes into play. If we give ourselves 3 days to complete a 1 day project, the time needed to complete the work expands to the time we give ourselves, even when a similar result can be achieved in 1 day. That's definitely something I need to work on, achieving more while doing less. I always give myself 1 week to complete a video. And during that period, I realized that's all I can do, no more or less, spreading the task comfortably over the week, even though I could have done more. I used the time to perfect every detail, thinking that I'm being productive. But yet, I'm just fine-tuning redundant work and ignoring the law of diminishing returns. Because no matter how much more time I put in it, the returns will not be as great. What I should have done is shorten the deadline and work on other videos or projects once I'm done with it. So we can use lesser time by applying high quality input. That's a perfect way we can use the mantra quality over quantity. Purpose. What minimalism taught me is extreme focus or productivity is not everything. Again, it's not about flexing how much I have hustled or how I complete the whole week worth of work within 24 hours. Being able to maximize our productivity in this generation is essential, but it's also important for us to know the purpose. That's how we can use our time meaningfully. For me, I want to get into the flow and have extreme focus at the right time. Accomplish what has to be done within a lesser time so I can use the extra time on things I value. That can be spending quality time with my loved ones, or I can use the time for myself to reflect or learn something new. I'm trying my best to live by the 888 rule. That's a work-life balance rule that can keep our lives in check. By splitting our day equally into 8 hours of work, leisure, and sleep. Of course, there are still slight variations. And I think this is a really good rule for us to find balance. If I'm working too hard, which is rarely the case, I can pull myself back. So obviously, I don't need that currently. But if I'm slacking too much, this is the rule that can push me forward. If you're interested in this, I have a detailed video on that, so you can check it out after this. So that's how minimalism helps me to boost my productivity. But don't misunderstand, I'm still vulnerable to fall back into procrastination. I'm not perfect, and that doesn't mean that every minimalist has no distraction. However, having less, it allows me to focus more on my priority. And in this case, minimalism is not a solution, but it makes it easier for us to get into the flow and achieve extreme productivity. So that's all I have for you guys. I hope this can be helpful. And if you are interested in more videos like this, you can check out my channel. I have other videos on minimalism and self-development on the channel. If you think this video is practical and helpful, you can help me with the like button and follow me on my Instagram. I'll keep you guys updated. I have a Patreon page. That's where you can support this channel monetarily. I'm extremely grateful for that. Once again, thanks for watching this, and I shall see you guys again next week.